Maggie.
Hi.
I need you inside. Jerry's made a hieroglyphic version of Pictionary.
Can you believe it? He's really gonna show.
And do you think holding some kind of a vigil out here is a good idea?
Am I being childish?
Considering he was supposed to be here 2 days ago waiting for us.
I know. I shouldn't be so wound up, but I can't help myself.
You know, except for the occasional picture, you haven't seen or heard from him in, what, like 20 years? I just want you to manage your expectations, that's all. In case he doesn't return the same enthusiasm.
Of course he will. He's my dad.
Let's hope so. You can never really know for sure who anybody is.
I most certainly do.
And you know that how?
You can feel it. Don't you ever get feelings?
Yeah. And I ignore them like any sane person should.
Weren't you supposed to be bringing her inside?
She tried. I'm gonna wait out here.
And miss all the high-stakes drama of Jerry's hiro, whatever it is.
Hello? You guys better not be bailing. I spent all night making this thing.
Trelawney's finally showing up.
Really? He's coming today?
Yeah, he's
right,
coming
now?
Right now?
Hey, guys. For
come
minute?
On.
So, come on.
We're
come
actually on, gonna meet him. Can you go inside?
How do I look?
Please?
All right. You heard her. Party's over.
All right, you heard her.
The party is over.
Margaret, look at you. What a beautiful young woman you've become.
Hello.
Get over here and give your old man a hug. My. You look just like your mother. I loved her more than life itself. Which means I will love you even more. Oh, I see you brought the whole gang for moral support.
Professor Trelawney, pleasure to finally meet you. I've heard quite a bit about you.
I'm sure you have. You know, one can't leave a footprint that lasts if you're always walking on your tiptoes.
Dad, this is Veronica Korbach.
Ah, yes. I'm forever in your debt. You know, I don't think I could have gotten my daughter out here without you.
Great to finally meet you, too. I've been a big fan.
Ah.
Forever.
Seems I have quite a few these days.
I'm Jerry. Grant?
Yes, indeed. You're the young lady who found the last two burial lanterns.
That's right.
Well, I must say, I'm a fan of yours. Well done, my dear. Well done.
Oh, lastly, but not in the least, Sarah Winchester, Kelly Kennedy.
Kennedy. Guten Abend. It's so refreshing to be working with such young and energetic spirits again. Now, who wants to join me for a drink?
You must have had a very long trip. I'm sure you're tired.
Not in the least. But it's all great here for you. You'll soon find out your old man's one tough customer.
So, this is you. See you in the morning.
Before you run off, I have something for you. It's not the original, mind you. It's been missing for decades. But it's an excellent copy, one of two hand-drafted replicas.
Where on earth did you get this?
Azerbaijan, of all places. One of my little Armenian blokes dug it up. Expensive, but well worth it.
This mapping is incredible. It looks like it'll lead us right there.
I imagine that's the idea. Although we'll still need Miss Winchester to translate the finer details. Unless you Deutsch sprechen. No, you hold on to that for now.
I hope you're not trying to bribe me.
Maggie, now I know I haven't done a very good job of being there for you, and I am sorry. But as cliche as that sounds, I did have my reasons.
Come on, let's forget it. We're together now, for what I hope will be a very long time.
Well, if it's up to me, my dear, it'll be forever. Mahaba.
Masa al-khair.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Fandina, please. I'm Madhu, your liaison from the SCA. Forgive the intrusion, but I cannot guide you into that region tomorrow. And for your own safety, I must have your permit revoked. There is an evil in that valley, a great, great evil. It's warned that all those that enter the valley in search of the Nameless One will never return.
Anak Baha Rahim Enon Kotep. Anak Baha Rahim Enon Kotep. Anak Baha Rahim Anankotep. Anak Baha Rahim Anankotep. Terakafu. Thank you. Iman and Gisam Pio.
Valley of the Sorcerer. Now I see why your government guides would not take you there.
But you will, right? You're not afraid of any old superstition.
Libyan border guards are not a myth. They do many excursions across the border. Mostly at night, but sometimes during the day. Looking for prey, such as you and your group. In this case, we are not just guides. No, no, no. We are also protection. Intibu, we will need more money. And up front.
700 US cash, not a penny more. Half now, half when we get back.
Like a sharmuta. And what will you do when we won't take you?
I'm sure there's no shortage of guides who will jump at 700 US cash.
شو رأيك؟
خلاص ماشي 700 تمام
أيوة حسن جدا
I think the term is we have a deal يلا
Mr. Mavir dropped out, so we had to find an alternative.
So, these guys pulled a permit?
We won't need one, for now. My father and I came up with a workaround.
Don't tell me you drank the Kool-Aid after just one day. He's not even supposed to be part of an archaeological dig in this country, let alone leading one.
He's not leading one. I am.
Then how about you stick to the rules so he doesn't ruin your career before it even gets started?
Come on, we'll be fine.
They are very strict about digs in this country. You know that? Trelawney knows that?
Knows what, my dear?
That we need a permit.
Not if we're only going to find the tomb. We're fine as long as we don't take anything out. Shall we? Days wasting.
I don't know. That sounds like the archaeologist's version of just the tip.
And we all know how much you like to play that game.
Excuse me, Professor?
Yes?
I've been reading through this, and it seems that part of it's missing.
Really?
Yeah. All the pages after Van Hine gets to the tomb. It's like they were removed.
Indeed it does. It appears my little Armenian friends have pulled a fast one on me. Sold me damaged goods, that dirty little swindler.
So, now what?
A history is there for us to write.
We should leave the equipment. We're not even going into the tomb.
Just be sure to top off your water bottle. You gotta stay hydrated out here.
Let's head out, okay?
دير بالك عليهم سمعت؟ وذكر لازم نكون هون قبل الشمس بتروح.
أكيد.
What was all that about?
Nothing, my dear. Nothing. Just for us to move along. Come on, chop chop. Yalla.
So, what was that great evil that had our Mr. Matthew so freaked out?
Oh, nothing. Just some cock and bull. Help selling the mystery that Egypt is.
You seem pretty convincing.
You certainly have the Trelawney determination. In ancient days, there was a great sorcerer, a king or a queen. All record of their being erased from history for all time. A great, great sorcerer that had no name as there was no name. And anyone who should say its name would waste away in life so that at death, nothing of him would remain to be raised again in the other world.
And that is who we're looking for?
That, my dear, is who we are going to find. Shall we?
Disjointed hieroglyphics at the entrance of the tomb? Placed there to confuse the messengers of Anubis. Come on, let's go. Here it is.
can't believe it. It's really here.
What does our man Van Hine have to say now?
Hey, hold up a sec. What do you say we head back to the village? Track down Mario and the permit.
Now?
I would just hate for you to lose this find because of some impropriety.
I told you we weren't going into the tomb until after we were permitted, and I meant it. I'm the boss, remember?
Yeah. Sorry, boss.
What do they want? It can't be time to go yet. The sun doesn't set for hours.
Sure, it's nothing. Best if you keep working and I'll look into this.
Is something wrong? It sounded like something's wrong.
I'm sure everything's all right.
He sounded pretty urgent.
Come on, let's go take a look for ourselves.
It is not safe to be here right now.
Don't waste my time, okay?
I don't see anything.
It's probably just a ploy to extort some extra money from your old man. They do this all the time.
Hey, what about that dust cloud? It looks like it's getting closer.
Dust cloud? Must you?
Whatever it is, I'm sure it'll pass right by us. We're all the way up here on the top of a mountain, right?
Come on. Don't we have more important things to do?
Yeah, we do. Come on. We'll be fine. My dad's not gonna let anything bad happen to us.
The Libyan guards are
here! It's your job! That's what you're paid to do!
If they are here right now, we must go!
Well, you take care of it!
I will take care of it! Go inside right now!
I thought you translated all this.
Well, now that that's out of the way.
See? False alarm. Everything all right?
Oh. Yes, of course it is. Just a lot of talk about fuel charges, overtime pay. More importantly, what's going on over here?
Right now, a whole lot of nothing. Seems someone's Deutsch is a little bit rusty.
It seems we've hit a bit of a speed bump.
Yes. Well, it was going a bit too smoothly, wasn't it?
His notes do get pretty cryptic at this point.
Upon further investigation, I discovered the key was in the construction of the plow, although one would never have imagined it so. Then the letters A-M, A-M, P-M-D.
Then the word bear.
Therein.
Is written in the margin.
Over the word plow.
Assembly of the plow.
Or assembly in the plow or in the bear.
Yes. The beauty of 17th century colloquialisms. Any other clues or words of wisdom?
That's it.
He writes that by the time they got the tomb open, the sun had set, so his guards made him leave. Then a few pages about how he was so excited he couldn't sleep.
Staring jubilant at the guiding heavens above.
But then it ends.
Assembly of the plow. Or bear, huh?
Maybe he's talking about Большая Медведица, the Big Dipper. You know, it is part of the Ursa Major, the bear.
In Kafkas, the Big Dipper is known as Plug, the plow.
That does look like the constellation.
The Egyptians called it the Forever Stars. In this latitude, the constellation never disappeared from the night sky and thus symbolized eternity.
And those letters, A-M-A-M-P-M-D, are the first initials of the seven stars. The key is in the order of the stars' formation.
Come on!
يلا هي تبي وانتبه وقرب وقرب اللي بيجي قرب
فوق الجبل
Fireworks. More like campfire.
I think our guides are under attack.
Them.
I don't know.
As they can't get in here, we should be fine.
I want to pose a practical question. What happens when we don't show up at the hotel tonight? Won't they send someone?
We didn't use a permanent guide, so no one even knows we're out.
Not to worry, my dears. We'll be just fine. Had a similar situation many years ago on a dig outside Wadi Halfa in northern Sudan. Had us holed up for days.
Hey. Everything all right? So I'll take that as a yes?
Maggie.
I don't want to say I told you so,
then
but...
Then don't. Okay, so we've hit a bit of a setback.
A setback is waking up hungover 20 minutes before a midterm. This is insanity.
It's an adventure. Think of how great this will be in your memoirs.
That's if I'm alive long enough to write them.
Nonsense. Come on, we'll be fine. We will, I promise. Trust me.
Maggie, you, I trust.
He's not going to let anything bad happen to us. He won't. I know it. I'm his daughter.
Hey, you guys better get back in here.
Gone? What do you mean gone?
See for yourself.
He went in there without saying anything.
Like, I was supposed to stop him? One minute your dad's going on and on about being stuck in that Sudanese tomb and how they found some kind of back door to get out. And then he started talking to Winchester in German. And like, 2 seconds later, this.
Jeez. This guy is a piece of work.
He's been going on expeditions since before any of us were born. I'm pretty sure he knows what he's doing.
That's what I'm afraid of.
So is that a way out then?
I'm sure if it was, I'd be back by now. It probably just leads deeper into the tomb.
Winchester! Professor!
We should go in after them.
Yeah, you are your father's daughter, all right.
I'm coming with you.
Jerry, maybe it's best if you stay here.
I've been on other expeditions, you know. I've got a pretty good idea of what to do.
Well, I'm sure you do, but you need someone to stay here with them.
More fodder for the memoirs, huh?
Winchester! Professor! You've got to be kidding me.
They didn't just vanish into thin air. Look down there.
More hallway. Hard to believe your old man squeezed through here.
He's certainly no stranger to a tight spot.
He's definitely determined, I'll give him that.
He is indeed. Shall we?
Did you guys hear that?
What?
It sounded like a growl. Like a lion? Please. Enough already.
Think they'll be gone long?
No idea.
Because if you guys don't mind, I need a little something to take the edge off.
Where on earth do you get weed?
At the hotel.
You can't smoke that in here.
Of course I can. I've got a med card for it.
That don't mean shit in Egypt. They'll throw your ass in jail without a second thought.
Don't sweat it. This will be gone way before anybody gets in here. Either of you want to hit? You?
She's already a paranoid hypochondriac. Do we really have to exacerbate things?
I'm not paranoid.
No? You just heard a lion growl. You take a one.
I was right about the dust cloud. Look, if you guys had listened to me, we wouldn't be stuck in this mess.
You sure? Might help calm your nerves.
No, thanks.
Too bad. Works wonders for me.
Maggie, you have anything to be nervous about?
Hey, I don't have to justify myself to you. I've been through shit that no kid should know. Shit that fucks you up for life. June 14th, 1995, City of Budonovsk. Chechen rebels stormed the hospital. I was there with my mother. She was executed right in front of me. For the next 2 days, I was locked in a closet with dozens of dead and dying. I don't do well in tight, confined spaces. This helps me deal with it.
What do you say? Try some?
Trust me, a couple of hits and you'll be totally relaxed. Help keep your mind off all this noise. Come on. Telling me a Beantown girl like you has never gotten high before?
Oh, Dad! Oh my God, you scared the shit out of me.
There, my dear. No need for alarm. We're fine.
What were you guys thinking? I can't believe you just took off like that. Don't we have enough trouble on our hands already?
Not at all, my dear. We're on to the most fantastic discovery.
Oh, come on, let's go.
Look. Maggie, Anankhetep, high priest and royal guardian, here to serve the Nameless One.
We're really gonna find him.
Yes, and the secrets of where they rest will be in here.
This is amazing.
Yes.
God.
Yes, the mutilation of the body ensured that he'd only be resurrected in the spirit world. And Ankhotep's primary task would be to ward off any messengers in the afterlife. According to the legend, the Nameless One had no intention of journeying to the kingdom of the dead. Instead, he would wait here in the tomb for millennia, until the day that he would be resurrected again into the mortal world.
Professor, what about this back door Jerry heard you talking about?
Yes, of course. If this tomb was constructed like the others of the day, which I believe it was, there would be one near the workers' chamber.
Great. So where do we find that? Sounds like a scream.
Oh, that sounds like Kennedy.
Jerry?
It's me. I'm here.
What happened? Are you all right?
Oh my God, Maggie, thank God. She's dead. Oh my God. She's dead.
Something I could do.
For starters, the father-daughter fantasy, get over it. Now it's a nightmare.
Hey, that's not fair.
No? Kelly's dead because of it.
This wasn't his fault. This was an accident.
Maggie, we're all culpable. We followed him out here and we shouldn't have.
It's not like he wanted this to happen.
No one wanted the Titanic to hit that iceberg either, but it happened. Maggie, I don't know what kind of Svengali hold he has over you, but you've got to snap out of it. From here on out, Abel Trelawney wants to take off on his own, we let him. We stay as a group, find our own way through this mess. Agreed?
I hope everything's all right back there.
I'm sure they're fine. Probably just Miss Kennedy looking for attention.
Maybe we should go and see.
Do as you wish, my dear. My time will be much better served here.
What was that?
I believe it's an incantation used in the resurrection process.
Wow. Could you imagine that, right?
So, what happened?
Astar. She's the one that got Kelly stoned.
Why would she bring weed with you to Egypt?
I didn't. I got her at the hotel.
I was probably laced with PCP.
Hey, I smoked it too. And I didn't freak out.
Not everyone reacts the same way. You ought to know that.
I'm telling you, Maggie, it wasn't the pot. Nothing happened to me. There was something else going on with her that made her freak out. One second she was fine, and then before we could move, she ran out of here. We heard her scream, and then this huge crash.
Come on. We should go find the others.
Right. Let's grab our stuff and go.
Wait, what? What are we gonna do? With Kelly?
We're gonna have to leave her here. Just until we can come back with the authorities.
And how do you suppose we're gonna do that, huh? There's like 10 tons of rock blocking the door.
We're never getting out of here, are we? We're just gonna die in here.
Come on, don't say that. I know we'll get out of here. You heard my father. He's been in situations like this before. I know he'll know a way for us to get out. Let's just grab our stuff and go.
Oh, great.
I'm seriously thinking we should go back.
Well, why don't we see where this will lead us instead?
I don't know.
Where is your sense of adventure? Hmm? Trust me, you'll find this infinitely more fascinating.
What about everyone else?
They'll catch up. There is only one way to go. Suit yourself.
Let's get our stuff.
Anak Baha Rahim Enon Kotep Kafu Enon Koper.
Sarah? Dad? Professor? Sarah? Professor, what are you doing? Are you all right? Ronnie?
Maggie, thank God it's you.
Oh my God, Ronnie. You scared the shit out of us. After you crawled in here, you collapsed and started having a seizure. I didn't know what to do.
I'm sorry. I don't know what happened. It's like I just totally blacked out.
Come on, nonsense. You have nothing to apologize for. I just thank God you're all right. That's all that matters. You probably got dehydrated from all the stress and the heat. Here. Drink some water. We should all have some water. Hey, take it easy. We don't want you to choke. Better?
Yeah. I've never been so scared in my life.
Well, you're all right now. You're with us.
Where's Sarah and your dad?
I don't know. They weren't in here.
Why can't they just stay put?
That's something I've been wondering my whole life.
Okay, so what's the plan now?
We keep looking.
And find this mysterious secret exit. Maybe there's a clue in here. Once we meet up with them, our first priority is to find a way out of this place. Not the royal burial chamber.
Of course.
I'm gonna hold you to it because I don't get the impression your dad has the same objective.
Of course he does.
Really?
Anak Baha Rahim Anon Kotep Tara Kafu. Anak Baha Rahim Anon Kotep Tara Kafu. Anak Baha Rahim Anon Kotep Tera Kafu.
Oh no.
Maggie, we're in trouble. There must be something in the air, like a microbe or bacteria. And the longer we're exposed to it, the more likely it is that we'll all end up dead.
Anak Baha Rahim Anan Kotep Terakafo Anak Baha Rahim Anan Kotep Anak Baha Rahim Anan Kotep Terakafo.
Dad? So now what?
We pick one of these passages.
Which one?
Dad? No, just relax.
Hey, we could
split up?
No.
We need to stay together.
I don't know. I can't go in there.
It's all right. You don't have to crawl that far, then it opens up into a tunnel. Come on, Maggie's waiting for us. I'll help you through it.
It's okay. Come on.
Thank you.
Fuck. Dead end.
Wait. Do you feel that?
Fresh air.
Now we need to figure out how to get help. Maybe we can make our way back down to the trucks.
You guys go without me.
What?
I have to go back and try to find my dad.
Maggie, three of our friends already died in there. It's too dangerous.
I have to go try to find him.
No, Maggie, please. You're not thinking clearly.
Yes, I am. Ronnie, you can't control every situation.
This has nothing to do with control. This is about common sense.
No, Ronnie. You're only about control, controlling everyone and everything. Just stop it. You remember in Washington when all those people left our project? It wasn't because the project was too difficult. It was because you were. Ronnie, you're my best friend. I love you like a sister. You know I would do anything for you, but sometimes you need to just let go.
I'm sorry, but I'm staying out here. There's no way I can go back in there.
Anak, Baharahim Anon Koteb, Tera Kafu, Nan Nietowa, Iman.
Ronnie, where are you? Ronnie? Ronnie, are you all right?
Down here.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I think so. It doesn't feel like anything's broken.
Can you see a way out?
No, I don't think so.
Oh my God.
What is it?
This is some kind of burial pit. Maggie, you can't leave me in here. I don't want to die in here.
You won't, Ronnie. You won't, I swear. Just hang tight for just 1 minute. I'm gonna go find a way to get you out.
Anak, Bahar. Anankotep. Terakafu. Anak. Baha. Rahim. Anankotep. Terakafu.
Magnificent, isn't she?
Dad! Oh my God! I can't believe it. It's really you. You're all right.
Of course I am, my dear.
I thought I'd never see you again.
Of course you would. Maggie, the nameless one. Terra, daughter of the sun, monarch of the north and south, queen of the Egypts.
Anak Baha Rahim Enon Kotep. Anak Baha Rahim Terra Kafu.
God, we're in trouble. We have to go.
There, my dear. Don't worry.
Please, please. We're in trouble. Ronnie's in trouble. We have to go. Please, we're in trouble. You have to help me now. She's gonna die.
Ah!
going to kill me.
Without you, none of this would have been possible. No, my queen.